I'm Elisa, the Scrappy Wife behind ScrappyWife.com, and today I have a memory planning process video for you. I am working through the week of October 18th through the 24th, and this week I'm going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to do a black and white spread. I actually printed my photos in black and white. They turned out a little bit darker than I thought they would, but that's okay. And I have some black and white paper from the paper person shop that I received in, I think this might have been the August subscription kit. So I'm planning on using that. And then I also have a bunch of black and white ephemera pieces pulled out that I thought I would use as well. So I will put you guys on fast forward. I will link everything that I end up using down below. Otherwise, let's go. I wanted to try something a little bit different this week, so I'm going to do a big cluster of photos all at the bottom of the paper. But first, I'm going to do some scrapbook paper. I have this sheet. It's just Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and Saturday. So there's like one Tuesday. I don't know. It was a weird. I didn't see Mondays on there. It was interesting that I didn't see all the days of the week. But I'm just going to use it as the basis at the bottom, so I'll cut 3-inch strips with my Fiskars paper trimmer. Someone told me that this was no longer in stock, which is really sad, like that they don't make it anymore. I happen to really, really like this paper trimmer. So if you do see it online, I'll link it on Amazon. I still find it on Amazon. So if you do see it, definitely pick it up because I don't know that they're producing it anymore. All right, here are all of the photos from this week that I'm going to cut apart, and I'm just going to mat them on some different black and white paper to kind of spread across the page. I don't know why I chose black and white for this week. It just kind of came to me when I was prepping for this particular project, and I thought it'd be fun to change it up. The pictures ended up a little bit darker than I intended, but I think that's okay. For the most part, we're doing a lot of white on the spread and just some pops of black, so I think the pictures end up balancing nicely, and I actually don't end up using the close-up pictures of my kiddos. I'll save that for a different spread, most likely. So I'll have some clusters at the bottom, and then I'll have a few other pictures here and there across the week, just because I had some that I didn't want to leave out. I ended up with a lot of pictures from this past week, so there was a lot to document for sure. Okay, so here's where I'm going to mat all the pictures. I kind of just use a variety of the different papers. These are all from the paper person shop. I decided to go with patterns on the bottom, and then the pictures that are kind of floating up top, those will all be matted in black paper. So I went back and forth on if I wanted to save these 4x6 cards or use the black and white on the back of them. I kind of switched up and did both kinds. So one of the cards that I didn't think I would use, I used the back of that paper. That's one thing about the paper person shop that makes me a little sad, is trying to figure out which side to use. You do get the digital file, so I could reprint these cards, but I like having the thickness of the cardstock for sure. All right, and then black matting for these pictures on the top. And once that is done, again, when I work in my memory planner, I go from big to little. So the biggest thing would be the paper in the background that had to go first. And then I worked on my photos, getting those in the right places and getting those matted. And then I'll start adding embellishments as I begin to put the whole thing together. I divide all of my ephemera and paper pieces, or the majority of it at least, by color family. And so I have a whole little container of black and white pieces, and I have all of these little cameras. I believe they're from a Maggie Holmes paper that I just fussy cut out all of the cameras. And then I have a ton of florals from a different black and white floral paper that I also kind of trimmed out that need a little bit more trimming. I just kind of roughly cut some out. And so I'm going to mix the cameras and the florals. I like that these florals are much lighter feeling, so they're not really heavy. And then the cameras, of course, are mostly black with just white lines. And so I thought the two went together really nicely. And of course, cameras are always going to be great when you're doing memory documenting, because they're very appropriate for the subject. This would have been a very fall themed week. In fact, I even talked about the fall weather coming in this particular week, how everything got a little bit cooler, but I decided not to go with a fall spread, just changing it up, trying something new. But florals and cameras will always go together, in my opinion, and then they'll always go with memory keeping. So I feel like they're kind of one of those universal statements that you can use in a lot of different ways. So I take some time to trim out several of these flowers so that they will be available when I start kind of piecing the spread together. It got a little bit tricky. Now I'm remembering why I only
just very gently fussy cut them at the beginning, because it can tire your hand out doing all that fussy cutting. So groups of the pictures at the bottom, and then I'll kind of tuck in some florals here and there. And then every place that there's a floral, I will also include a camera. So we'll add pictures on both sides. I'm just kind of playing with the layout, making sure that they fit all the way across and that it's not too matchy-matchy on either side, if that makes sense. So we'll start to put the cameras in some different places. And I also want to make sure I'm using some different cameras. There were several different kinds, and I wanted to make sure I wasn't repeating any of the kinds. So once I'm happy with that, we will start adhering things down to the page. Just as always, what always happens is once I start putting things down, sometimes I change my mind. I kind of shift pictures around. I didn't want them to be quite so linear like I had them lined up originally, so I dropped one a little bit lower, which actually made a little bit more room for the camera up top, and then I can still tuck in pieces here and there. And I really like how it came together on the bottom. I think it's a pretty cool effect, and actually a little part of me wishes that I hadn't had photos for the top, that I had just done writing on the top, but that's okay. I had a lot to document, and the purpose of this is documenting these photos, getting them down on paper so that I can just share them with my family. I love getting to look through this memory album, and as we get closer to the end of the year, it's going to be so special that I have a whole year of memories already documented. I'm actually really proud that I've stayed on top of it, and I'll have 18 months done when it comes to this December. Actually not 18 months, more like 14 months done, not 18 months at all, but still a full year for sure. So that'll be awesome to be able to flip through as we get closer to 2022. Because I had done the florals and the camera at the bottom, I figured I should probably do some combination of that at the top. So with my few pieces that I have left, I will trim those out and then use them tucked behind some of the different photos. That way it continues the same theme, and I can just figure out where I want all of those to be placed, tucking it here and there. Just four separate little photos that just didn't fit with the clusters at the bottom, and each one will have a floral near it and also a camera of some sort as we kind of bring this together. So it was fun. This was kind of a different spread. I mean, it's still my normal, like on the weeks, mostly on the days that things happen, still writing with the lines and, you know, getting the story down, but I liked changing up the color scheme. I think it would probably be fun to do a whole series of like monochromatic pages where I just pick one main color and kind of go with that. So stay tuned. That might be something that I try here in the near future. So using the most of my florals by cutting them in half and sticking them on different parts of the page. And now I'm just looking for different camera choices. So I have a lot of different cameras on the page, and I wanted to make sure I wasn't repeating certain cameras. So you'll see those come in a little bit different. All right, black and white washi, had it pulled out, decided to go with the hearts here just to add a little washi. I'm trying to use my washi more. I really love washi tape, and I like fell hard for it a few years ago when I first started Bible journaling and collected a ton of it. And so I have a ton in my stash, and I definitely want to make sure that I'm using it. So we'll do these hearts up here at the top, and then at the bottom, I'm going to go with a darker washi. We'll go with the skinny black one, and it has some spotty dots on it. So I'll put that down. At first, it was on the bottom. I'll end up putting it on the top of most of these photos, almost like it is what is keeping the photo on the page, just to add, you know, a little bit more interest here and there. It's fun. It's fun to play with the washi tape. So I decide I'm going to definitely move that one over, but I'll go ahead and add it across the page just so it makes sense visually to me, and then I'll move that third piece up from the bottom to the top so that it all kind of matches as it goes across the page. All right, so for me, the next step would be adding the lines on the page. I'm just going to use my T ruler to add lines across the page. I've tried it a few different ways recently. I think I like this method the best, just more room for writing, but I'll probably change it up from, you know, every now and then. I got a little bit off on this side, so it ran into this main line. So the lines end up being a little funky, not my favorite, but that's okay. It happens. And once I put the lines in, I realized I had a couple of blank spots. So I'm going to kind of find a camera that can go in each of those spots. And over on the left side where I have that sidebar, I'm definitely going to need a floral as well. So I'm kind of looking through, looking for another camera, and I'm looking for a different kind of camera that's not already on the left-hand side. And so I was struggling just a bit because that one definitely matches one that's like right there. So that looks odd. It just doesn't look right. And so I end up, you'll see what I end up doing. So that one's not going to work. There's already one there. I don't have another option that's a different kind of camera. So I'm going to choose this larger one, but I'm just going to cut off the top part of it so that it looks a little bit different. That might not look very different to you, but it does to me. So that counts. I'll fussy cut this floral, get it down, and then off camera, I will add in all of the journaling. And that is it for this memory planning process. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider hitting that subscribe button as well as the bell notification button. I have linked the supplies that I could find online down below, so make sure to check those out in the description box if you're interested. And I also want to give a huge shout out to my Scrappy YouTube members. You guys make it possible for me to continue putting videos out there, and I really appreciate it. If you're interested in becoming a Scrappy YouTube member, then make sure to click the join button, or there will be a link in the description box. All right, I hope you have a fabulous day, and as always, keep it creative.